Assalamualaikum. How's your day going? Do you miss coming to school? Well, even I'm missing you all so much, and I'm very excited to see you all back to school, and I'm eagerly waiting to see you all back. Well, let's start with a new lesson in Islamic. Okay, so children, before starting our lesson, I'm going to ask you all some questions, and I hope you all will answer it correctly. Okay, so my question is, whom do you love the most? Your mom or your daddy? Whom do you love the most? Your dad, because he brings you toys and gifts and chocolates? Or do you love your mom because she takes care of you and cooks tasty food for you? Is it that? Okay, one more question for you. And children, who loves you more, your mom or your dad? What do you all think? Okay, so both your parents love you a lot, and you should also love them. And we should be thankful and say Alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us such lovely parents. Isn't it, children? Okay, so do you all know that who loves you more than your parents? Think, who can that be who loves you more than your parents? Think. Yes, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He loves you more than your parents and more than anything in the world. Yes? So He is the one loves you more than your parents and more than anything. So you should also love Him more than your parents. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you, so you should also love Him. Okay? So our today's lesson is, I love God and He loves me. This is our fourth chapter. I love God and He loves me. This is our lesson's name. So we are going to see, why should we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how much should we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us. So first of all, we should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He gave us life. So we should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He gave us life. He brought us in the world. Then there are so many things for which we should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and also thank Him. I love Allah because He gave me eyes to see things that I love. Isn't it, children? He gave us eyes so we can see so many beautiful things around us, so many colors around us. Isn't it? So what is your favorite thing to see? Is it cartoon? Or are they cute animals? Yes, so there are so many different things to see with the eyes. Then He gave me a nose to smell wonderful things. Yes, He gave us such a precious nose so we can smell different types of things like flower, tasty food, your chocolates, and so many things you can smell with the help of your nose. And also, Allah gave me ears to hear all kinds of wonderful sound. Like in the morning, you all can hear the birds singing and chirping around. Yes? And also, you can hear your mother calling, father calling, your friends calling to you with the help of ears. Yes? So see how important ears are to us. And we should be thankful that Allah gave us such things. Then He also gave me a mouth to smile, talk and laugh. I also use my mouth to eat and drink. Isn't it? We laugh with our mouth, right? We smile, we talk to our friends, parents, and also we laugh so much. So He gave us such a beautiful mouth. I also use my mouth to eat and drink. So you can eat and drink tasty foods and drink tasty juices with the help of your mouth. Yes, and you can taste all these things differently. Does the chocolate and food taste the same? No, the chocolate tastes sweet and the food is little spicy. Yes, so we know that each things taste different because of our mouth, because of our tongue, isn't it? Yes. And then Allah gave me the sense of touch. I can feel soft and smooth things. I can feel cool and I can feel warm. So He gave the sense of touch. It means we can feel soft and smooth things. We can feel the hard things like the wall, the stones. These are all hard things, right? And soft things like your teddy bear, like your clothes, those are all soft. And then you can feel cool also. While it's winter, you can feel cool. And while it's summer, you can feel warm and hot. Yes, because of the sense of touch. So, I love Allah because He loves me and He takes care of me. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who takes care of you more than your parents. Then Allah gave me parents and teachers to teach me good things. Yes, the most important thing He gave us, parents and teachers, so they can teach you such good things. He gave me house to live in, clothes to wear, and food to eat. Yes, He gave you such a beautiful house to live, and clothes to wear, colorful clothes to wear, and food to eat. So see children, there are so many things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given us to eat, in sweets, in food, in ice creams. There are so many things, right? So we should be thankful to Him. Then Allah gave me very important thing, that is water to drink and clean myself. Yes, we need water, right? From the day we wake up till the time we sleep, isn't it? We need so much of water to drink. Then we need water to clean ourselves for drinking, bathing, cooking. There are so many things we need water. Then He gave me friends to laugh, learn and play with. Yes, children, do you all have friends in your class and around your house? Yes, so there are so many friends He gave to laugh, learn and play with them. Yes, then last thing is Allah gave me family and friends. Yes, we should be very happy that He gave us family and friends. So, we should love Allah because He loves me. And most important, He made us a Muslim. Yes, He brought us to this world and He made us Muslim. So, and the most important thing, He gave us family and friends. You should be thankful that He have given you both the parents and you live with them very happily. You should say Alhamdulillah for whatever He has given to you. So children, we saw so many things that Allah has given us, and this shows that Allah loves us so much, isn't it? So children, what should we do so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love it? And what should we do because we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We should show Allah that you love Him by doing good things. Yes, good things means what? You should listen to your parents. You should pray 5 times a day. You should love your parents, respect them, respect your elders, help them. And also these are all good things. So when you do these all good things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to know that you love Him and you are doing all the good things. Now when we will do all these good things, He will show you that He loves you also by giving you gifts in this life and in the next life. So children, as you will show him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you love him by doing good things like praying 5 times, obeying your parents, helping them, respecting elders, all these good things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also show you all that he loves
you
by giving you gifts. Yes? Now what gifts? That he have given you such a beautiful home. He will give you toys. He will give you clothes. He will give you tasty food. And also Allah will give you Jannat, means paradise. You all know Jannah? Yes, that is called paradise. That will be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's biggest gift to you all if we do all the good things to him. And we should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is all we saw. We saw that we should love Allah because of so many things he have given us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us because we do good things. We listen to everyone. We listen to our elders. We do not trouble them and so on. So children, I hope you all have understood the lesson and you will obey to your parents and listen to whatever they are saying. And also be thankful and say Alhamdulillah for whatever you have been blessed. Thank you. Take care.